Good morning, everybody. I hope you all are fit and fine at your homes. Welcome back to English class. So, children, yes, we have already completed our chapter number 3, that is the magpie's nest. As children, as we all know, that magpie is the name of a bird. Yes, magpie is the name of a cleverest bird. So, children, yes, in the last class, we have discussed section A. Then we also have discussed section B. Yes, children, then section C. Then also we have learned about personal pronouns. Yes, children. Then we have learned about adjectives. So, children, what is meant by adjective? Yes, tell me. Adjective is a word which describes the quality and quantity of a noun and pronoun. Yes, it's called adjectives. So, children, words that describes naming words. Yes, are describing words. These words are called adjectives. Yes, children. So, in the last class, we have discussed about adjectives. Then, so children, in the last class, we also have discussed about synonyms. So, children, tell me what is meant by synonyms. Yes. So, synonym means, here you can see, like for example, Priya run very fast. Priya run very quickly. Yes, they are similar in meaning. Yes, children. So, synonyms are similar in meaning. Yes. So, they are synonyms. So, here children, we also have learned some synonyms like big, large, clean, tidy, then hard, tough, right, wrong, right, correct, bright, shiny. Yes. So, words which are similar in meaning, they are called synonyms. Okay. The spellings are different, but the meaning is same, are called synonyms. Okay. So now children, come to the page number 37. Okay. So in today's class, we are going to learn about antonyms. Okay. So children, tell me what is meant by antonyms. Antonymous, synonymous, antonymous. So children, tell me what is meant by antonymous. Synonyms and antonyms. So children, here read these sentences. Ram come late to school. Rama come late to school. Here, underline the word late. Okay. So children, see here. Rama come late to school. Yes, Rama came late to school. So here the words late and early. Nandini came early to school. Rama came late to school. So children, the words late and early are opposite in meanings. Yes, late opposite is early. Early opposite is late. Yes, children. So here underline the word late and early. So children, the words late and early are opposites its meaning. Yes, so they are called antonyms. Okay, so a words which are in opposite, which meanings are opposite, it's called antonyms. Okay, so for example, here you can see the words late and early are opposites in meaning, so they are called antonyms. Okay, is that clear? So now come to the section B. Here see children, pick a word from the box and write it next to the word that is opposite to its meaning. So here what we have to do, we have to pick a word from this box. Here you can see, yes, they have given one box. Yes. So what we have to do, children, we have to pick a word from the box and we have to write it next to the word that is opposite to its meaning. Yes, children. So in the last class, we have also learned about opposite words. Yes, I hope you have watched that video. Yes, children. So narrow. Yes, narrow means chota, small. Broad means bada, big. Yes, so narrow opposite is broad. Then heavy. Heavy means wazan, wazandar. Then light means light. Yes, heavy opposite is light. Narrow opposite is broad. Heavy opposite is light. Yes, then short. Short means what? Short means chota. Long means lamba. So short ka opposite kya hota hai bachcho? Long. Yes. Then outside, inside. Old, new. Yes. Cold, hot. Long, short. Then tell me some more examples. Tell me some more opposite words. Yes. Thin, fat. Yes. short, long, inside, outside, heavy, light, narrow, broad. Yes? Day, night. So these are opposite words. Okay? These are called antonyms. Okay? Antonyms, synonyms. Okay? Antonyms, synonyms. So children, here come to the section C. This is your homework. Okay? So here children, the names of some birds are given in the box. First, look at in this box. Here, they have given one box. Yes? So here in this box, yes, the names of some birds are given in the box. So what we have to do? We have to find them in the grid. Okay? We have to find them in the grid. So here the names of the birds are pigeon, hen, duck, vulture and cuckoo. Okay? So cuckoo bird, yes? So pigeon, hen, duck and vulture. So here let's find out, okay, the names of a bird. So here children, see, wait, here you can see here, yes, pigeon, yes, P-I-G-E-O-N, pigeon, yes, pigeon. So here ऐसे ही क्या करना है बच्चों आपको वर्ड इस जो बर्ड्स के जो नेम्स हैं इस ग्रिड में आपको क्या करना है मार्क करना है ओके सो व्हाट यू हैव टू डू चिल्ड्रन यू हैव टू फाइंड द नेम्स ऑफ द बर्ड्स इन दिस ग्रिड ओके दिस इज योर होमवर्क जैसे अभी मैंने यहाँ पे एक किया है यस P-I-G-E-O-N, pigeon. Yes, इसी तरह से आपको hen, duck, vulture and cuckoo birds के नेम से यहाँ पे आपको find करना है okay? This is your homework. So children, now turn the page. So children, see here, come to the page number 39. Okay, so in the last class, in previous classes, we have already learned about vowels and short vowels and long vowels. So children, tell me how many vowels are there in English alphabets? There are totally 5 vowels in English alphabet. So what are they? Yes, A, E, I, O, U. Yes, A, E, I, O, U. Yes, so totally there are 5 vowels. Then 21 consonants, isn't it? So children, so short vowels are short sounding and long vowels are long sounding. Yes, seat is long sounding vowel. Sit is short sounding vowel. Yes, so here remember the sounds you practice. Say these words aloud. Short, short. Short, short. Cot, cot. Cot, cot. Spot, sport. Short, short. Short, short. Cot, cot. Spot, sport. Yes, children. So here we have already learned about vowels, long vowels and short vowels. Yes. Now come to the speaking activity. Work in pairs. Use the timetable from the listening activity to ask and answer questions like the ones you heard. Yes, speaking on a topic. So praising. Praising means kisi ki tarif karna. Yes, praise karna. So when we want to praise or appreciate someone for doing something well, we use this words. Yes, bacho. Agar kisi ne acha job, acha work kiya, kuch acha kiya, to hum usse kya karte hain? Hum usse praise karte hain. Usko, uski kaam ko hum kya karte hain? Appreciate karte hain. Yes, children, तो हम उसे कैसे अप्रिशिएट करते हैं किस वर्ड्स का यूज़ करते हैं अगर हमें किसी को अप्रिशिएट करना है या फिर किसी को हमें क्या करना है कुछ कॉन्ग्रेचुलेट करना है देन किसी को प्रेज करना है उसकी अच्छाई के लिए उसने जो वर्क किया है उसके लिए उसको अगर हमें कॉन्ग्रेचुलेट करना है या फिर प्रेज करना है या फिर अप्रिशिएट करना है तो हम किस वर्ड्स का यूज़ करते हैं Yes, children, when we want to praise or appreciate someone for doing something well, what we use these words like wonderful, great job, congratulations, well done, bravo, yes? So we use these words. आप use करते हो किसी को appreciate करने के लिए, yes? अगर आपका जो fellow classmate है, अगर वो first आता है, तो आप क्या करते हो? यस आप कॉन्ग्रेचुलेट करते हो उसको, यस कैसे करते हो, यस कॉन्ग्रेचुलेशंस ऐसे आप बोलते हो, यस सो लाइक दैट चिल्ड्रन व्हेन वी वांट टू प्रेज और अप्रिशिएट समवन फॉर डूइंग समथिंग वेल वी यूज दिस वर्ड्स लाइक कॉन्ग्रेचुलेशंस वेल डन देन वंडरफुल यस ग्रेट जॉब देन ब्रावो यस सो वी यूज दिस वर्ड्स इजंट इट सो चिल्ड्रन सो द चिल्ड्रन The next we will discuss in next class, okay? So till then stay home, stay safe, okay children? In the next class we will discuss this section B, then section C, okay? So children, till then what you have to do, you have to write synonyms and antonyms, okay? Okay children, and send it to my personal number. Okay, the next we will continue in our next class. Till then, stay home, stay safe. Thank you. Bye-bye.